Darcy'd forgotten the very thing that makes a dragon unique. Unlike a horse, a dragon, of course, breathes fire whenever he speaks. Off to town dear Darcy went, but woe is me, oh lament. Before a dragon penny was spent, he'd started a tiny fire. He said he was sorry, our Darcy did, he helped put the fire out. The folks forgave him, for he'd been kind, and off he went looking about. Into the toy shop did Darcy go, with thoughts of his forest friends. I'll buy each a game, he said, with the flame, and the second fire it was then. And this time when the fire was out, the villagers charged along, pursuing Darcy with angry shouts, be off, away, be gone. For Darcy sparked, no harm I meant, but from the village he was sent. And woe is me, and oh lament, no presents for his friends. Darcy was sad as he sat at the edge of the forest by and by. No gifts would he have to offer his friends, a tear rolled from his eye. A storm did gather and soon did hit, 'twas a mighty wind that blew. And Christmas snow did whirl and blow, and he wondered what to do. As Darcy let out with a dragon's cry, he opened his mouth so wide that the wind and snow went right down his throat and put out the fire inside. When Darcy realized the fire was out, first a whisper, then a shout, and a laugh to know that he could speak without starting another fire. But now it was late on a Christmas Eve, he was up and off with a roar. He raced to the village and he cried out, my fire, he am no more. From shop to shop he then did go, in each he made his choice. Darcy was treated so kindly now, no need to fear his voice. The villagers came to the edge of town, and Darcy waved goodbye. Come back again if ever you can, they said, and he said that he'd try. Merry Christmas, all did say, as to the woods he made his way. Tomorrow will be Christmas Day, and a Merry Christmas to thee.